just a big bike event up here.
Wine Cellar Bar. When did you first begin to develop an interest in wine distribution?
Well, interest in wine started when I was in Ottawa, drinking Mogan David and Manischewitz with my Jewish friends. And then when they weren't around, I was still drinking it because we used to have these grape gropes at Carleton University. And, you know, there would be tubs of this wine. I was introduced to wine that way. And then, of course, when I'd go on a date, I'd bring Matus Rosé or a baby deer or a baby duck for the girlfriend, you know. And so that was my taste, very unsophisticated. I moved to New York, I started to drink Beaujolais. It was very light, you know, and I thought it's not much exciting there. We started to do the Blues Brothers. We went out to California, started shooting there. Steve Cropper, our guitar player, Donald Duck Dunn, man, there would be no Blues Brothers without them. We used to have parties up at Steve's place after work. And we would go up there, and he opened up his wine cellar to us, turned me on to Big Napa's, Sonoma's, Mount Helen, Washington wines, you know, all the big Bordeaux's, and you know, it ruined my for life, because that's all I want to do is drink the good wine now. So that went on, and I began to develop an interest with Isaac Tigret in the Hard Rock and House of Blues, and we had to buy wine and taste wine and know about wine. Then I brought the Patron up into Canada, partnered with a distributor that has four vineyards, and they said, why don't we do a line of wines? Yeah. You know, you like it, let's put it at a point where the consumer can get a $100 Bordeaux experience for $70.95, and I think we've got that with the Cab Merlot. Yeah. If you air it out, you gotta let it sit for a half hour.
The other thing was, are you mostly focusing on wines now, or is there still movie projects in the work?
Well, it would have to be, I'd have to get a call from Steven Spielberg or Adam Sandler or Tom Cruise to go out the door on a movie, because I've got this, the concert business with the blood brother of Jake Blues, brother Z Blues, Jim Belushi, a.k.a. Jim Belushi, correct? And also we've got the House of Blues expanding around the world, so I have to be available and make myself available and free to go and publicize them and get them, get them around into Connecticut, where we're going to be, and then Houston.
Well, the Ghostbusters game's starting up, too. And one thing people have noticed about that is the script you wrote for Ghostbusters 3, it's not the same script. Are you hoping with the springboard for the 1991 Ghostbusters 3 game maybe to start up into a Ghostbusters 3 movie in the future?
Well, the script that I wrote for the third movie will have the elements of that will be in this game. And, of course, you hit it right on the nail on the head, man. If the game is popular, maybe everyone's going to have to say, well, we have to make another one.
Yeah.
I mean, as a fan of the franchise, objectively, I miss it. I wish there was a third one coming on.
Well, I mean, it seems like the biggest stepping stone so far has just been convincing Murray to do. Like, why is he so, generally what people have found is the Murray Kane, you know?
Yeah, the Murray Kane.
Yeah.
Is onto other things. I don't blame him. I mean, he's onto other things. He wants to do novel things.
Yeah.
But he said he'd come back if it was a CGI where he could do his voice.
Yeah.
And he's participating in the game with us.
Yeah.
So we're all right that way.
There's been a lot of photos of it online. And, I mean, it's
yeah.
a game that's a year away.
Mm-hmm.
It's hyped to the gills already.
No,
already taken pre-orders for
no it's insane. It's going to be great. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And Murray will be a part of it, which I love.
Because everybody, they're pretty well saying everybody, even Dickless is coming back.
Everybody's coming back. We got them all. Except Rick, but I don't know. We'll maybe work on him.
I think he's retired, too, isn't he?
Well, he had a country record there, a little back, but it went very, very well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I guess, you know.